对那个读书的空间或者是library 只是其中的一个方面，我们是希望它能够在这里更多的是一个最后还是回归到它的一个精神上的一个感觉，它可以在这里面有一种与天对话的一种感觉。
This part of my journey took me 400 kilometers north of Beijing to the Hebei province. After driving through some ruggedly beautiful mountain landscapes, I arrive in the grassland of Inner Mongolia. I'm here to see the Mulan Weichang Library and Visitor Center. It's mid-April and spring is near. Golden brown patches litter the land, the vestiges of a prolonged winter. Sitting alone in the valley, surrounded by grazing sheep, is a yurt or Mongolian ger, the shape and form which inspires the design of the library. To learn more about the significance of the design, I met up with the architect, Zhang Haiyo, from HDD, a design firm based in Shanghai.
那么第一个呢，可能就是我们最显著特征的一个蒙古族的文化，我们是从蒙古族那个蒙古包里提取出来的。那么第二个呢，就是说我们把两个这个蒙古包咬合在一起，那形成的是一个满族的一个双环万寿亭的这样的一个文化属性。从那个鸟瞰的这个视点看出两个圆的一个交汇嘛，那么在这个汉族的这个文化当中代表着如意的一个形状。所以说我们认为呢，我们这个建筑就是说把三个民族的这种文化就全部的融合在一起了。
Historically, Weichang was a vital region for both the Manchus and the Mongols and served as the hunting grounds of the Manchurian rulers of the Qing Dynasty, a tradition that started by Emperor Kongxi in 1681.
那么我认为呢，在这个设计当中最重要的一点呢，其实是它的文化，就是说建筑所能承载的文化方面的属性啊，不仅仅是它表面的所在的一种设计的氛围。
When I stepped into the library, the vertical lines of the building and the bookshelves led my eyes upwards to the glass ceiling. It was grand and awesome. I felt as if the sky had extended an invitation for me to sit amongst the heavens.
我们在那个内部空间做了很多放射性的这个书架啊，那这个代表着太阳的光芒，也是蒙古族的一个文化。
To my surprise, the library doubles as a residential space. With three bedrooms, a dining room, and a kitchen, I felt an immediate desire to stay here, to live here for a while. I could see myself sitting around the fire pit at night, gazing up at the constellations, as many Manchurian warriors had done generations ago. I daydream about waking up in the natural sunlight and taking a bath with a view that makes me feel like a small cog in a larger universe. Unfortunately, it is currently only open for daytime visits. The strategic placement of the windows allows the scenery to grace each space around the building. They are like telescopes, pointing in all directions, framing different aspects of the landscape. Salvaged stone and wood from nearby villages remained exposed, reminding us of the wild landscape just beyond. A small stargazing room sits off to the side of the library. The structure is made of reflective metal so it can capture the landscape and camouflage itself in its surroundings. The shape of the library is like two gears joined together, a full circle combined with 3/4 of a circle, representing the sun and the moon. From above, it looks like I'm entering a magical space station. While the library remains a spectacular reason to visit, Weichang has other unique features that attract tourists from bigger cities. There is a museum that showcases both Mongol and Manchu cultures. I also learned that it's potato country. The region produces 600 million kilograms of potatoes a year, and there's even a museum dedicated to the crop. I tried some of the tastiest potato dishes and other local cuisine. I also sampled Daqing hunting wine, a sorghum and millet liquor that has a bite to it and will keep you warm at night. The The Weichang Library and Visitor Center is a place to read, but it's also a space to feel the light and the sky and to connect with nature and its stunning landscape. Weichang has been educational and enlightening. I wish I could stay, but duty calls. For my next stop, the Seashore Public Library in Beidaihe. The library would like to keep its doors open to the local community and kids. Please help by donating books to